Konnichiwa, Namaste, I am Abhishek and welcome to Kanji Mnemonics channel where you will learn kanjis in a fun and creative way. We will use the technique of mnemonics, that is associating images with kanji characters so that you can learn them faster and effectively for the JLPT exams. In previous videos, we have covered 8 kanjis and today we will cover a new kanji. If you haven't watched the previous videos, then the link would be in the description below. Please visit the link and watch those videos and learn the kanjis. Now for the new kanji, let's get started. The kanji of today is Now we will go through the process of mnemonics and we will learn how to identify the meaning of this kanji character naturally so that you have the highest chance of remembering and recollecting it in the time of exam. Now before we answer this question about the meaning of this kanji, we have to split this kanji into its radicals, that is the building block of this kanji. I am mentioning the radicals on the left hand side. Now, as you can see, this particular kanji can be split into its two radicals. This is the first radical and this is the second radical. Now, the thing about the radical is that usually the radicals should be memorized or they should be remembered, and those radicals in together can form a meaning to that kanji. Now, this is referred to as the roof radical. And this is referred to as the leg. Now, once you keep in mind the meaning of these two radicals, you can notice that when this radical is used in conjugation with the roof radical, the symbol changes. In this, it is a very flat and a curved one, and in this, it is simply a curved character. Now, to come to the literal meaning of this particular kanji, the way I memorized or the way the mnemonic technique I used is, this is the roof of the room and this is the pillar or wall, and this particular is the floor. And this part is the ground. Now, think of a cave, that is in which our ancient people or our ancestors used to live in a very, very long time ago, or even right now in the animals that they live, like we can think of a wild animal. So, a cave is basically made on the ground, and this is the top portion of it, which can be referred to as roof, and this is the wall. So, the difference between this a home and a cave is that the flooring or the tile portion is missing. This particular cave is also on the ground and this particular home is also on the ground, but there is also a floor part in this, and this is simply on the ground. Now I associated this roof with this radical, and I associated this wall or this pillar This radical, is it leg, support? Is that the legs support our body? So in this way, this wall and pillar is symbolized by this leg. So if I conjugate it together, then this should give the meaning of cave. And that's how I remembered this kanji is the meaning of cave. Now, I will show you a picture in order to further strengthen this particular mnemonic technique that is used and also to associate another meaning, another literal meaning of this kanji. This man is inside a cave and this picture is taken from inside the cave. Now, as you visualize this particular portion which is opening to the outside world, this gives an image of a hole, right? And the other meaning of this kanji is hole. So this kanji has two meaning. One is a cave, or say as a den, something like that, and hole. And the mnemonic technique that we use is, this is the roof portion, this is the roof radical, and this is the leg radical, which is when it is conjugated, it forms a different shape in its presentation. Other like this, it forms a simple inclined character. And in a home and a cave, there is a difference is that there is no flooring like in cave. A cave has this roof, this roof portion and the pillars to support that roof, but it is naturally on the ground. There is no flooring, there is a natural ground which is used as the base. However, in a home, there is this flooring above the ground. And as in this kanji, there is this only this roof and this leg portion, that is the pillar or the support to the roof. So this gives a meaning of cave. And when you see this image from the inside of a cave to the outside world, this gives this image of a hole, a big hole. And that is what another second meaning of this kanji. Now we will cover the un and kun reading of this kanji. Kun reading of this kanji is ana. The un reading of this kanji is ketsu. Now we will form some common words that are using this un reading and kun reading of this kanji, which will be helpful for you in your regular conversation. The common words associated with the kun reading of this kanji is ana, which I have already covered, which means hole. Now second word is ana ume. This ume word means to fill, and ana ume means fill in the hole or fill in the blanks. Kaze ana, kaza ana. This kaza means wind. In previous videos we have learned that the kanji pronunciation for wind is kaze, but the other way of pronunciation is kaza. So kaza ani is ventilator. Do ketsu. Now this is the un reading of this kanji, do ketsu, which itself means cave or den, and buketsu means grave. Now we will go to the next section, which is the sentence making. Now we can use this particular word ana in a sentence like chuishite kudasai, sono douro ni ana ga aitemasu. I repeat, chuishite kudasai, sono douro ni ana ga aitemasu, which can be translated as be careful. Chuishite kudasai, be careful. Sono douro ni, on that road, ana ga aitemasu, there is a hole in that road. Another sentence that you can form using this ana is, for example, kakaricho ga kyū ni yamemashita node watashi ga sono ana ni umenakereba naranakatta. I repeat, kakaricho ga kyū ni yamemashita node watashi ga sono ana ni umenakereba naranakatta, which means The person in charge went on leave immediately, so I had to fill in his place with all my efforts. Kakaricho means in charge, person in charge. Kakaricho ga kyuni, suddenly. Kyuni means suddenly. And previously also we have done ana ume means fill in the blanks. Ume is the word, umeru means to fill. So ume na kereba nara na kata, that is the form which means I had to fill the void or fill the space. The third sentence that we can make using the word ana is like this. Anata no giron ni ana ga takusan aitemasu. I repeat, anata no giron ni ana ga takusan aitemasu, which can be translated as anata no giron means in your argument ana ga takusan, a lot of loophole exist, aitemasu exist. So friends, we have covered this particular kanji, which means this roof and this floor gives the meaning of cave, and the other meaning is hole, which you can find it out, which you can associate with a memory. When a person from the inside is looking at the outside, he sees this as a big hole. A big hole exists here. So these are the two meanings of this particular kanji. We learned the kun and un reading of this kanji, and we learned some few commonly used words and three example sentences. This N1 is the JLPT categorization of the kanji, and 136 is the frequency of the usage of this kanji in the day-to-day usage of the kanji in the literature, newspaper, etc. So I hope this particular kanji explanation is helpful for you in learning your kanji journey, and this will be helpful for your JLPT exams also. And I would again request you to please share your comments and your opinions and any particular kanji mnemonic technique that you want. We'll be again back with a new kanji technique. So see you soon, and thank you very much.